Dear students, let's study the grouping of parallel plate capacitors. About grouping, we can simply write that replacing combinations of several capacitors by a single equivalent capacitor is called capacitor grouping or grouping of capacitors. And there are many ways in which capacitors can be combined, like in your early classes you might have studied about series and parallel combination of resistances. Similar to that, capacitors, parallel plate capacitors can be connected in series, and a combination of series can be connected with other capacitor in parallel like this, or there can be many ways in which capacitors can be connected. And say if this is a group of capacitors and there are two terminals for the group of capacitors, say A and B. If it is replaced by a single capacitor which we can term as C equivalent, then the C equivalent can be written as equivalent capacitance of this group of capacitor, and its capacitance should be such that the same amount of energy will be stored by the single capacitor which is stored by the whole group of capacitor when a potential difference is applied across it. Or we can say if this group is connected across a battery of potential difference V along with a switch, and if the equivalent capacitor is connected across the same battery of potential difference V along with a switch, and if these switches are closed down, then to charge the group of capacitor, the battery will transfer a charge delta Q from one side to the other side of the group. Then work done by the battery in charging of this capacitor group up to its steady state will be delta QV. Then if this capacitor is having the equivalent capacitance of the whole group, then we can say on closing the switch, same amount of charge delta Q will flow through the battery, and the same amount of work will be done by the battery in charging the single capacitor up to steady state. Similarly, we can say the total charge on the terminal plates of the equivalent capacitance as well as on the terminal plates of the group of capacitors must be equal, because this is the equivalent capacitance. In this situation, we can say if Ceq is the equivalent capacitance, the charge supplied by the battery in charging the capacitor up to steady state will be C equivalent multiplied by the potential difference. So for a given group of capacitors, if we are required to find the value of C equivalent, this equivalent capacitance can be written as delta Q. The amount of charge which is flown through the battery, it can also be written as delta QF divided by the battery potential difference. This is the way how we can calculate in general the equivalent capacitance for a given group of capacitors. In coming sections, we are going to discuss about some standard combinations like series and parallel combination of parallel plate capacitors, as well as mixed combinations also.